स्टॉप शेपर्ड के लिए शेयर दो इस इंटरेक्शन में
नाटिन स्लीप
Sir, could you stop sharing your screen so that
Sure, I can. Yes, I can.
So, with your permission, shall we start?
Yes, please. You can start. I'm just trying to stop my screen sharing.
Good morning to all. Welcome to the second session of the last day of our FDP Phase 2 program. It is sponsored by AICTE and organized by the Department of Biotechnology, the Oxford College of Engineering. And we have our guest speaker today, Dr. Manpreet Singh Manna, who is a former director of AICTE and currently is associate professor, Department of Electrical and Instrumentation Engineering, SLIET, Longowal, Punjab.
Dr. Man, Institute of Engineering and Technology, Patiala, and Dr. Manpreet Singh Manna, born in Patiala, Punjab, graduated in Electrical and Electronic Engineering from Mysore University in the year 1993. He did his ME from Thapar Institute of Engineering and Technology, Patiala, and PhD from SLIET, from where he started his teaching profession as a lecturer in the year 1997. He attained the position of Director of All India Council for Technical Education under Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India, New Delhi, on deputation from 2014 to 2018. During his 4 years tenure in AICTE, he also worked as Director of SWAYAM MOOC's project and Prime Minister's Special Scholarship Scheme, PMSSS. SWAYAM is the world's largest MOOCs platform developed by MHRD, Government of India, for providing unique educational opportunities to citizens of India. With his persistent efforts and the able guidance of his seniors at MHRD and AICTE, he completed the development of SWAYAM platform for hosting the online courses within a record time and declared the same go live for public well before the stipulated target, and for which Dr. Manna received the Commendation Award from the Honorable President of India during the launch of the SWAYAM platform. Dr. Manna successfully organized the Swachhata Ranking 2017 award ceremony on 14 September 2017 at the Ashok, New Delhi. Dr. Manna was invited by UNO Geneva for delivering a special talk on SWAYAM MOOCs. He also led the delegation from India with invitation from BRICS International Forum and Ministry of Energy, Russia, at Moscow during Energy Week of Russia from 3rd to 6th October 2018. He has published about 140 research publications for leading national and international journals and attended a number of conferences in the field of engineering and technology. He is also serving as editor and reviewer for many international referred journals, books, and AICTE news bulletin. He has also contributed chapters for various prominent technical education books. He edited one exclusive book for faculty entitled Higher Education Faculty Career Orientation and Advancement, published by CEGR in 2017. Apart from the Commendation Award 2017, felicitated by the Honorable President of India, Dr. Manna has been conferred with the following awards: Commendation Award 2017, Editor Choice Education Excellency Award 2019, Weaving Dreams Digital Leaders of India Award 2019, Eminent Engineer Award 2017, Medal of Honor 2018, Exceptional Leaders of Excellence 2017, Innovative Policy Maker Award 2017, Rashtriya Shiksha Gaurav Puraskar 2015, Outstanding Faculty Award 2015, Bharat Excellence Award, Vijayashree Award, Best Citizens of India Award, Shreshth Acharya Award in the year 2011. Thank you.
Sir, on behalf of the staff, students and the management, the Oxford College of Engineering, I take it a privilege to welcome you to the session of our FDP Phase 2, sir. Welcome, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much for inviting me on this event. And I hope the present now by this presentation, there would not be any spike in the power and I would be in position to give my presentation seamlessly. So actually today there is a raining here and this and just recently in near to hostel number 7 some lightning stroke happened due to which that transformer got damaged and now they have started the generator set. I hope my this presentation, unfortunately UPS is not working, so but I hope with our best wishes and positive wishes we are able to be find something. So this FDP, as the most of the faculty members though have been joined this FDP and they have taken away the very fruitful discussions, material, of course, brainstormings with the very renowned speakers. Those came from this area of expertise and they delivered their best of the content to the participants who have joined this FDP. I'm really thankful to Professor Manjunath and the whole team of the Oxford College of Engineering, including their honorable chancellor, chairman, deans, directors, because it's a teamwork. When you work for something kind of event organization or maybe some conferences, etc., it's a teamwork and we need everyone to be participate in that sense, that whoever is going to be coming from the outer world, either in the form of speaker or a guest or a special guest or a participant, they should take away not only that value which you are going to deliver, the ambience, the expressions, and of course that feel which is giving us that we should visit again, we should come again, we should be well connected with each other with this kind of world, you know, professional world as well as the educational world. So in this, I especially chosen this topic, although I'm not from the area of agriculture or maybe even biotechnology, but still it's a greatness of the team and the Professor Manjunath Dehi have opted me. Then I have to make justice myself. Then I search, I discuss, I do get something to be present before you and to make you to be get connected, not only to stick to the my presentation, but it can be one beginning thing which you can take away with you. So today we are going to discuss in this my talk, IoT, the Internet of Things. You know, when we are talking IoT, it is not only one area. It is in a biomedical engineering, it is in a electronics and communication, it's in a computer science. Then of course it is in agriculture as well as the biotechnology area also. Today when we talk about the Bluetooth technology, we talk about the internet technology, we talk about any kind of blockchain or now many kind of tools from the artificial intelligence world which is coming. So IoT is a very broad area. Anything which you can do through internet is called IoT, that is Internet of Things. So it means you are connecting your devices, your gadgets, your any kind of a weather forecasting or maybe your sewing machine, anything. If it is going to be get connected with the internet, it is the IoT. So the very first application, if we talk about something in agriculture or especially in the bioagriculture, the robotics. The robots have come a long way in the third industry of revolution, because many areas where a human being may not travel due to some geographical conditions, geometrical conditions, or sometimes the weather conditions. If all of a sudden you feel that your crop is finally ready to be get harvest, and suddenly you came to know that today is a heavy rain, the thunderstorms are going to be come, or maybe some hailstorms are going to be come, you have to cover your crop with the help of some, you know, the sheep, other things. Do you think we will put our brother's sister's life in a danger to be standing in the field at that time? Maybe any light striking can happen as it happened today, just half an hour before in my campus itself. So at that time, this Roberts can be, the unmanned aerial vehicles can be deployed to make this kind of, you know, detect and exterminate weeds from the field. They could save farmers' time, human resources, and of course, the spray. You know, sometimes we are going to spray some pesticide. Somewhere we throw in the high density, somewhere we could not throw well. So half of the crop is going to be get even enriched of the pesticide, which is again harmful for the body. Or somewhere our crop is going to get damaged due to some worms or maybe, you know, insecticides because my pesticides could not be sprayed in a uniform. So when we are using this kind of, you know, robotic approach or many other kind of approach, look at the market. Look at the market. The attractive opportunities in the agriculture robot market is going to be touched to 20.3% USD billion. So this started by this last year, 4.6 is going to be touched. It is the CAGR data. Not only this data, you look at here to the other way, the growth, how the global market for the agricultural robots starting from this 2020 in a 5 years of domain, just see the spike. 7.4 billion US dollar economy, which we are going to touch 20.6 billion dollar economy expected by 2025. Just we are talking the one particular technology which is coming through this IoT tools, which is coming through the robotics in an agriculture area. It does mean that whoever a student is pursuing a B agriculture in your campus or biotechnology in your campus, they should be equally tech savvy. They should be taught under the value added courses, under the edge cutting courses with their curriculum, which curriculum you are already given to them. So this is the requirement. We have to bring some kind of curriculum change in the value added courses for the matching with the agriculture 4.0 readiness. Industry 4.0, we already have so many components to be added. We have to make an agriculture because my country, India, the, you know, the larger pie in my GDP is coming from the agriculture sector. So today we understand how agriculture is facing so many problems because of this weather conditions, very harsh weather conditions, or sometimes some policies of governments or state governments or central governments, and they have to save their, you know, fields, they have to save their economy. So these kind of technologies can help them to be, improve their income. On-field navigation, it's a machine learning, you know, the GPS trained Internet of Things. I recently about to file my patent about the GPS enabled stretcher. If any patient, a COVID patient is reaching to hospital because nobody can, you know, accompany him because of he is already in PP kit and no, you know, family members allowed to be come along with this. But he wants to reach to the particular place. The stretcher can be a GPS enabled, a navigation enabled, and it is a solar based stretcher, which I'm going to be again filing one patent, solar based stretcher, which I already have designed it. So same thing. It can be happened in our tractors, in our trolleys, in our so many other, you know, the agro tools, which can be reached out to the right place with the right time. Sitting at home with the mobile, you can track them. Because sometimes your field is so big, you left some equipment at one place and tomorrow, next day morning, where I left my kassi, you know, that my khurpa or wrench or something. So with the GPS navigation, because it has a sensors, because sometimes in the mall, it happens many times. You go to Delhi big mall, you park your vehicle and you don't record the pillar number. There are so many layers, you know, basement one, basement two, basement three. It one day, it was a hell of a thing for me. I took 2 hours to identify particular which particular mall because 3 malls are connected in Basant Kunj. I parked a vehicle in a one mall, I was searching another mall basement because my parking chit was lying in the car itself. I forgot in the car. So then they said, sir, until unless either you search, and I forgot to remember the pillar number and near which pillar number I parked. Now I do click photograph. I do click photograph on my mobile and I just put directions. through walking, I can reach to my car easily, because on my mobile, when I click the photograph, the latitude, the longitude, the direction of the car. Same thing in a field, sometimes you left the equipment one place, you are searching a whole day because your field is of 5 acres of land, maybe 10 acres of land. And it is a small equipment which has to be get attached with the tractor. Like, you know, different types of cutters, blades, etc. for this. So navigation is going to be very smooth. And this is one application I'm just going to give. Just see the IoT devices shipments globally happening. In 2020, it is going to be a 70 million, you know, devices shipment. It means people are aware. They know how to buy. And presently, Government of India, from last 2 years of budgets, they given a totally duty free. If you are buying any equipment from other country than India, even there is a no duty if it is an agricultural equipment. There are so many sophisticated agriculture. I will show some equipments today in during my this presentation. So it does mean that the shipments growth is so rising in a 5 years of time, reaching to 2020 is a 75 billion. It means our farmers are aware, but still we have to educate them. We have to educate with the conducting some workshops, some seminars. We should go to some villages. We adopted villages under Unnat Bharat. When we adopted villages under Unnat Bharat, we are not only looking the sanitation part. We are not looking only the health conditions. We are not looking only the road conditions. We should look what kind of their daily routine, how the farmer spending 8 to 18 hours in a field, and what kind of difficulties he's going to face. She is going to face when they are working in a field, and we should provide them certain experimental things, drones. Amazing. I'll tell you, the drones are just like a blessings for the agricultural area, the biotechnological area, because the new generation farmers are leveraging drones as a service. Predict the crop yields, diagnosis the pest infestation. Field is so large. You cannot walk through so easily, because when it is a, you know, already the crop, especially sugarcane crop and many kind of crops, they are very dense. You cannot walk through. The drone can tell where exactly there is a some strike of the tiddi dal, or maybe any kind of insecticides, or maybe where the fruits are ripe now. Because sometimes some area fruits are ripe and the other areas unripe. You say it will take days and days, but the drones with the camera, they will give you the exact location where the fruit is ready to be get plucked out. So you immediately go there and save your time and pluck the fruit, and fruit can go to the market through this processing well in time. So aerobotics is one of the few food tech startups that have made their mark in the field, literally, because they are combining the drone scouting and multi-sensor analysis to predict the crop health and of course their longevity. Sometimes what happens, the field is so large, one area the crop got the proper, you know, your irrigation, and some area is dry down because your irrigation, sometimes a blockage in the, you know, nalas, blockage in the canal, and the water could not reach to that level. Because of the drone, you will understand the, you know, the humidity, that then what kind of the forestation is going to be take place. All these things can be very easily, comfortably can be achieved. So I'm talking something in the field, and after the field, when you have collected your grain, you collected your food, you have to store somewhere, and the storage is again a very big. After the COVID, you know, in my states like Punjab, Haryana, Maharashtra, the all our Pravasi Mazdoor, like you know, the labor from the other states, they went back and they could not come because still COVID is there, and we are wasting our crop unattended, lying unattended. For that, the warehouse management is most important. The use of IoT in a warehouse management is known to be a recurrent top IoT trend. Inventory tracking, consumer a lot overheads and unaccounted muscle power in the food service industry. Because, you know, the big bags of the grain, you come to Punjab, sometimes I will show you, in a one day, 100 trucks are going to be get loaded from one mandi, from where it is goes to the finally that cold storage places in the or in the flour mills or maybe in the shellers where that rice is going to be taken out of their wheats. So the point is that if we have this kind of automated vehicles and automated arrangement through IoT in the big cold storage, you sometimes you have to search where you can put your 5 bags, where you can put the 10 bags, which bag is put where, which has to be first taken away, you know, that the clearances. Otherwise, if one bag is lying from 6 months or more than 6 months, then maybe some damage can happen due to the, you know, dampage area, or maybe that less oxygen content is given to that area. So we have to change the positions also, changing a stack, changing a position. So that management is very amazingly happened when with the IoT, because IoT through internet, you can track everything with the CCTV cameras, with this kind of a vehicle, which is reaching out and which is going to be take away the things that is going to be happen amazingly. So that these are the areas which we can definitely just look at here. This one model I just wanted to explain over here. When you are bringing, inventory, that is an in-house inventory you are going to bring in. So IoT cloud gathers inventory data. That's at the entry of the gate only the data is going to be get captured. And with the single click, you can tell how much grain is inside the cold storage, how much still it is going to be come in coming days. Then the ERP system, as ERP we are using very dedicated in institution, intake of students, marks of students, attendance of students, everything. Same thing over here. Same thing can be correlated with your desktop, with your mobiles. Then we have the proper inventory system. And whenever the customer comes, or maybe the government vehicle comes to collect the grain to be taken to the other part of the country or world, then they should know which particular grain, which particular field grain has been taken over here and where it is aligned, because the location. So IoT cloud gathers the dispatched inventory data from the warehouse, outgoing inventory. So there is no theft in our FCI godowns. I should not say, but it's happening, you know, due to corruption or something. They say 100 in, but it comes 20, 80 in and 20 on paper. When they go out, they say 100 out, but outside goes 120, 20 more, because there is no proper challan system, inventory execution system, entry system. So because of this IoT, which is controlled by the chief engineer sitting at home through mobile, they will come to know, because one truck, when is passing through the gate, what is the unladen weight of the truck and what is the laden weight of the truck? We can simply can tell how many bags of the grain are loaded by the truck. Yes, it is a simple, it is not a rocket science. It is a very simple thing. Because of 500 bags of 100 kg of each, we know how much total quintal of load is truck is carrying away. And every gate, there is a weighing scale. The vehicular weighing scale is lying. And it is IoT enabled. So sitting at home, the BDPO, the block development officer, or maybe the panchayat officer, he will come to know. Because sometimes the corruption happens at the lower level. They will give the bribe to the gatekeeper, security guard, or to the truck driver, and they take away some grain food outside. And later on, this account can never be matched. And it's happening many times, so many scams unearthed, other things. So these all kind of problems can be resolved with the help of this IoT. This is another area which I just wanted to explain. Now I'll come to the vision picking. Vision picking concept is again automated guided vehicles. We call it as AGVs. It's a collaborative job with the robots, because robots will travel along with them and they will put the things. So think Google Glass with a lot more information packet. Basically, every area, when we collect food or collect any vegetation, we know that there is a tier 1, tier 2, tier 3. And of course, accordingly that the selling is going to be take place. According to that, the age of the fruit and the food is going to be fixed. Suppose there is a one basket in which my semi-ripe tomatoes are there. They can remain with me for 15 days. But in one basket, the very ready tomatoes are there, which has to be go the market tomorrow itself. Otherwise, they are going to be rooted. And once they are going to be rooted, there is no use. But in the market, I will get a very good price, because it's a ready to eat, ready to prepare, ready to cook. So this kind of the vision picking, my food industry, my agriculture industry, my biotechnology industry can make the stacks. With the stacks and racks, they can have the IoT based for the storage zones. So I mean to say, It is not only the field area. It is not only the processing area. Now I'll come to the retailing part also. So this complete applications, starting from sowing the field. Jab aap bijai kar rahe hain, when you are just putting the seeds in the field, from that till reaching to the customer's end, means serving to your dining table, this whole process can be automated with the help of IoT. That's what I'm giving the examples. You are just making from these examples itself how it is going to be a very fruitful in that area, in that domain. So next part is the product authenticity label. It is very important. I just show you one picture. Look at here. There is a one packed bottle of maybe something, maybe sometimes oil or sharbat or syrup or even a grain. So we have to have the so many things to be get picture on it. What is that? Manufacturing history, real-time location, logistic performance, consumer engagement, product information, brand protection. Everything has to become labeled. And this labeling, this product authenticity labeling is very important, because in my country, India, you go to the market, you will find the two biscuit packets with the same packing, but one is the original, one is the local or altered. Simple, Bisleri bottle. You go to any bus stand or railway station, you are in hurry. You will pay 20 bucks and you will buy a Bisleri bottle, and you are happy that you, because it's a look like a Bisleri. But when you will closely read the spellings of the Bisleri, it's something missing. Either R is missing or E is double. You know, same blue color, same bottle shape, everything. And end of the day, you feel some, scary to drink. It can be a water. It can be a good water. Why they are doing this copying? Why doing this plagiarism? Because they are saving some money. Because my actual Bisleri water bottle may cost 20 as MRP. This may cost 10. So my retailer, my supplier, they have some malafide intention. Otherwise, why they are putting the same kind of package, same kind of color sticker, and to make a fool to the society, to the customers? That's why we require the product authenticity labels, like a hologram labels, etc. So with this barcode, which is available on this, you are clicking the barcode QR from your mobile, you will come to know the authenticity of the package, authenticity of the product, authenticity of the grains which are inbuilt. Otherwise, today, it is a very worrisome things. Many of the medicines are substandards. Many of the food materials are substandard, packed in the same format with small change in their logo and name. And we are always in hurry to buy and to eat. That is our fault. We should not be so much in hurry to buy and to feed. First, we should read it with a closed eye. What is the manufacturing date? What is the expiry date? Whether it is manufactured in the same company or same logo for which I am looking for this product. And for this, internet is helping us a lot. And we should take the help of the internet by looking to all this manufacturing history, the brand protection, the production information, the consumer engagement, etc. Otherwise, people can make us fool. So IoT complete, you will give you the information about this. Now I'll come to the crop harvesting. I told you earlier, because of the labor problem. Nowadays, the labor problem is a big problem throughout the country, not only in Karnataka, not only in Punjab. Wherever you go, there is a labor problem. Because semi-skilled labor is very much demanding outside India. People are traveling. Many people from Kerala, many people from Punjab, many people from other states like Bihar, they are traveling outside India because they get some dollars, they may get some francs, and they do same kind of hard work, but with the automated machines. Because when they stay in India, there is a true drawback they will see. One is the labor cost is low, and second is they have to do the hard work more. Means a whole day they have to cut the crop manually. If we will provide them this kind of the machines, this kind of the automated gadgets, and our productivity is going to be increased. And they will get sometimes a good human feel, because sometimes they are doing whole day. In a peak summer, you ask someone to go and 8 hours do something in a field. End of the day, he is a human being. He or she is a human being. We feel sometimes, so bad just because of rupees 300 or 500, 8 hours under the sun. And during that May, June, July in our North India, It's a too much peak of summer and it's very pinching, but they have to do. The crop cutting time, they have to be. So if this kind of the automated crop harvesting we can apply, the same person can do, I think, a 10 people's job. And maybe 10 people's are accommodated by other part, you know, cleaning, packaging, and stacking and other things. But many things we can be done with the automated crop harvesting because we are not getting the good number of labor human beings not available. And we want it. Why everybody should be always the labor? They should come to the semi-engineer, maybe junior engineer, or maybe skilled labor. So skilled labor may get a good salary. Their lifestyle is going to get changed. Our work is going to be, the productivity is going to be improved. That is the other way. This is the IoT. Now I'll tell you one amazing application, remote sensing. Because when I was in Thailand, AIT, in 2012, I was closely working with the Dr. Tripathi, who's the professor and having an international journal for remote sensing, particularly for the agriculture. So remote sensing in agriculture, it's having amazing, amazing features applications. Look at here, weather conditions, crop nutrition, soil pH, and many, many more. If we will properly using this remote sensing tools, which are available, the softwares are available, they will give you the spots like a red spot, which is a dry enough, the green spot where there is a greenery, because you know the soil strength, the crop nutrition, you even can't even judge with your naked eye, because you will put eye on a one particular zone, one particular area of the field. But from this remote sensing, you will capture the whole domain area of your field where which you are going to be test, and all the satellite images can be shared now. You see Google Map, you using a free open source Google Map, you will come to know where your car is parked now in the open area, because the fields are open area. It is not covered by some RCC. So it is a complete sunlight is there, complete raining is there. So with this, all pictures can be captured from satellite. So if you will tune to your field latitude and longitude through Google Map, you sitting at home, even a many, many kilometers away, you will come to know your field is dry. Somebody is doing something with your field, or some area of your field has to be looked after, or some stray animals are coming through your field. You have to safeguard, you have to close the doors, you have to put a barrier guard, something. So many monitoring system can be done with this remote sensing. So remote sensing is a very amazing application in an agriculture field. So that's one sharing with this production site, VRA salt, and of course, retailing side. Look at here, smart sensors, what they are doing it. Whatever the bag, you know, the bag which we are using to store the grains. If every bag we are putting a QR code, no theft can take place. Yes, no theft can take place. And from the bag QR code, once the bag is going to be filled with the grain, we are going to stitch it. Once you stitch it, with the QR code, you will come to know this bag started from which date, from which area, traveling schedule, reaching schedule, and no alterations can be take place in between. This is the QR code is amazing. Same QR code we are putting now for the food processing. You go and buy a bread, you go and buy a biscuit packet, you go and buy even a butter. You will first check the age of the butter, shelf age of the packet, a butter or maybe a sauce because of this QR code. Because QR code is given the moment when it's going to be come out from the production site, come out from the processing site. And this QR code is giving all the informations, just the veracity of the quality, but whether the sealing has been broken or not. The source of its ingredients, yada, yada. For the uninitiated, that is another way of the Internet of Things. Technology is transforming the industry of food. So it is not only the hybrid of seeds, it's a hybrid of the customer side also. We are giving these kind of options with the help of IoT. Look at here. These are the applications, the consumers and supply chain apps. IoT smart products platforms, uniform analytics to the track and optimize the things. Look at here, image recognitions, barcode, QR code, NFC, RFID. Anything is going away from the big bazaar. They will get you beep. Oh, you have not done the billing and you're taking away the article. so that you are in trouble. So it same thing can be happen in the warehouse. If in the warehouse somebody is going to be stealing some bags or maybe some products, it is going to be with the RFID, because all your bags are going to be RFID enables, and of course Bluetooth enabled, printed electronics, and of course sensors. Sensors nowadays we are putting in the field for the humidity control, for the sunshine control, rain control, and of course any kind of attacks by the animals or maybe the some birds. You know, Tiddi Dal, it's a very famous. Once they will strike on your crop, your 80 to 90% crop is going to get damaged. They spoil your crop like anything. Because of these sensors, if you get the threats, the communication, they are 2 kilometers away, 1 kilometer away, this kind of, you know, the sound they capture. You can do some arrangements, like some drones with the, some musical things. Now we're having some music on the drones. Because of this music, they get away. They diverted the route. Because all the mosquitoes, reptiles, they get controlled with the ultrasonic sound. With this ultrasonic sound, we are controlling the Tiddi Dal also by creating this. You know, earlier days, we used to play a thal with the chamach at fields, because we want to make them to be away, like crows, sparrows, etc. So now one tower having a camera system, wherever they see there is something happening with this, the drone goes there and give a sound. When the drone goes there and give a sound, they will just fly off and your crop is safe. And no human being is required to hold it to be make the protection and guarding the crops. That is the amazing thing. This is the complete packaging optimization with the help of IoT. I just wanted to be share on screen how the farmers get registered their products, producers verify and certified your products. I'll tell you, in my place, I used to buy some, you know, organic material, organic vegetable. Very few farmers are doing. We made a group. Whenever they are coming to the city with their very limited of tomatoes or oranges or anything, they put on a group. They put on a group, this much quantity at this time. We book from the group itself. Please 5 kg, 2 kg for me, 1/2 kg for me. We pay through Paytm. Now it is my headache to go and pick my product. If I don't go, they will give it to some others, maybe needy people. And my money is not refundable because he came for 1 hour, because he has to go back to the field. These kind of, you know, things are happening at the small level. Now apps are there, like Ola Uber, like Oyo Rooms. Now with the apps, you can book your organic food also. Organic food is limited nowadays because many farmers are not aware. They are doing still inorganic farming through the pesticides. And organic, you know, it has to be a bit costly also, because they will not get the yielding of the material or the grain as much as to the with the pesticides. With the pesticide, in a single day, you see the yielding. But for the organic, it takes even days and days. So they have to be cop up with this kind of expenditure. And like this kind of IoT apps are going to be very much useful for this kind of arrangements, which I am just showing over here. The distributors are delivering items, the retailers selling items, all are blockchain. It is under the blockchain, get well connected. And of course, we are using a complete system under this. We sitting at home, when I'm having one cereal spoon in my mouth, I know with the help of blockchain, which particular part of country, which particular farmer's field it has been grown and it processed and came to my house through this retailer. See, amazingly, means otherwise you are eating daily, but you doesn't know which area's grain you are enjoying, which particular vegetable you are enjoying, which particular fruit of which particular. Sometimes we want to give them blessings, you know, because they are fetching us. So these blessings can go in more effectively if we'll come to know the people truly they are working for us, they are doing the hard work for us, because they are andatas. So like this, all applications can be captured with the help of this IoT. This is what I just wanted to be cover in my field, and thank God there is no power spike and I could present my whole presentation before you, what I just wanted to present. That's all for today. Thank you very much for inviting me on this particular day when you are going to be having a validity session, and most of the participants already have taken a very good notes and the material from the different speakers during their FDP. So let the last day to be equally enjoyable. So I just given a glimpses. I have given the just glimpses of this area, which can be explored for your PhD work, for the postdoc work, for some research area. You can do the joint research. The biotechnology people should join with the computers people and do the joint research work. Maybe some paper publishing, maybe some articles, maybe some device, gadgets, because you know the one area, that is the biotechnology. They know the other area, that is the AI, that is IoT. Join hands, sit together, make algorithms, make flow charts, and make it very viable for the future. With this, I just stop here. Thank you very much. And I don't know how to stop sharing here. Better you make it stop sharing from your side only, from the organizer sides. And I'm available for further next 5 minutes if there is some discussions required at my end. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for this wonderful session. Sir, we will be participants. If you have any queries, please post it in the chat box, or you can unmute yourself and